This is a quick video about low budget mountain bike forks. So first you got to define low budget, and my definition of low budget equates with safety. So you can buy the super cheap ones, which is what came on these bikes. And if you buy a super cheap mountain bike fork, it's going to have a sticker on it. And that sticker is going to say, do not use for free ride, downhill, dirt jumping, or any hard riding. So what that sticker tells me is that this fork that looks every bit like a professional quality mountain bike fork has killed people, and they put the sticker on it so that they don't have to pay off the families of anybody else that dies with one of these crappy forks. And you know, they got cool graphics. This is a Suntour XCT. Now, we shouldn't be biased against Suntour. They just grabbed onto the bottom of the market making super cheap forks, and they also make decent forks, but that was not one of them. So rule number one, if your bike has a little yellow sticker on it that says don't do anything fun on it like that one does, then you better upgrade it if you're going to do anything fun. And it should also be said, if you're not going to do anything fun, if you're just going to ride to work, ride to school, you know, just go around the neighborhood, jump over curbs, then that fork would be perfectly fine for you. We found that we kept crashing and getting hurt using the cheaper forks on these bikes, so we went ahead and upgraded. And now when I say low budget, I'm also looking for features within a low budget category. So the features I want is, I want an air fork. So in this case, that cheap fork had steel springs, but this one's got an air valve in it, and you can fill it up so that it can have more or less spring pressure. So it's like having unlimited options in terms of how much springiness you're gonna have in your fork. You also wanna have damping
that you can control. So this is
compression damping. And then down at the bottom of the fork,
on one of the feet,
is your rebound damping. So the turtle means slow rebound. And then there's a rabbit on the other side that means fast.
Compression and rebound damping are very important to have, because depending on what you do, like when I ride it, I've pretty much got it set really loose, so it's just bouncing around, especially when we go to
Snow Summit and we're doing downhill. I'm not really crazy about the jumps, so I'll go on the trails that have a lot of rocks and stuff, and it's blah, 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 blah. But when my son's riding, he wants to have less bounciness and more firmness, because he's going off all the jumps. If you set that to be too loose and you're going off jumps, it can screw you up and it can bottom out. So to have the adjustability for whatever trail you ride is what you're looking for. So this one has it. This one, same deal here. There is a valve here and there's a crank here. On my son's bike,
we went with the Manitou
Markhor. It's got this weird satanic emblem on it. This side hasn't been crashed yet, so there you go. It's the Manitou Markhor.
Set up for a disc brake.
And in buying one of these, you want to make sure you know if you have the same size bearings top and bottom. Like your cheaper, crappier older bikes will have the same bearing size top and bottom. And a newer bike's going to have a fatter bearing on the bottom. So you want to make sure if it is a tapered fork that you buy the right size. And this fork is great. It's 3/4 pound lighter than the Rockshox that we're going to look at here in a minute. It's got skinnier tubes, so all your friends are going to make fun of you for skipping leg day. You can see the Rockshox has these big, fat, beefy forks, and this one's got these little skinny tubes. But Manitou claims that it's every bit as strong. They've just built them smaller, so it can be 3/4 pound lighter than your standard fork, and thus perform better and lighten up your bike if you're a weight weenie. Note that the cheap fork weighs about 6 pounds, so it's between 2 and 2.5 pounds heavier than these other forks. And then this one on my bike, my old hardtail, is a Rockshox Recon Silver, which is a classic. You know, Rockshox's been in the game forever. They'd be killing the game. It's got compression damping here. It's got
rebound damping here. So
I'm happy with both of them, whichever one you can find. And the price is around $200 to $250, depending on whether you can catch a sale or not. I think I paid like $220 for this one, and this one, $209, something like that. The Markhor came out, the Manitou Markhor came out in 2017. These Rockshox are a little bit older, so I'm not sure if they're still making them, but I'm sure Rockshox makes it. What you're looking for is an air fork that's adjustable with compression damping and rebound damping. And then both of these forks have a little guide on the back of them, which tells you how much air to put in the fork depending on how much you weigh. And you don't have to use that as an absolute guideline. You know, obviously you can ride it and get a feel for what works best
for your particular body size and weight.
And that brings up another good point, which is if you spend $1,500 on a fork and you're a pro grade rider, you'll get one of these pumps included with it. But if you're not, you won't. So this is a shock pump. I was able to get one of these for $20 on eBay. A lot of the pro guys who buy fancy forks have a whole bunch of them and they sell them on eBay. So I would look for one of these on eBay. And basically, it's just a mini pump that goes in there. And your air pressure is super high on these shocks. You can see it's 150, 200, 250, all the way up to 300 pounds. So they use a ton of pressure, which means your regular bike pump probably isn't going to go that high, number one. And number two, it might not fit. Like on Rockshox, they've recessed it to the point where you can't really get in here with a regular tire pump. So even if you wanted to attempt it with a regular tire pump, you can't. Manitou was smarter than that. They elevated the cap so that you can use, you know, you can go to the gas station and fill that up if you need to. Now let's look at these forks in action downhill at Snow Summit in Big Bear, California.
First up, this is the Manitou Markhor. This is the professional rider on a closed course. My son going down Snow Summit, just to give you an idea of the speeds and the altitude he's getting and the kind of terrain you can go over with this fork. It's still in great shape after, geez, probably a season of downhill mountain biking. And he's ripping on it and no complaints, works great. You can tune it to be bouncy, you can tune it to be firm. Like he likes it firmer because he does these kind of speeds. I'm a tired, slow old man, so I like it slower. So either way, it'll do what you need it to do. It's lighter than the Rockshox and every bit as strong as far as I can tell. I couldn't feel any flex or detect any negatives about it, and I like the adjustability. So big thumbs up for this one. And next up, we've got the Rockshox. Now this isn't entirely a fair comparison because it's on a hardtail going downhill, so we're not going to take it off any jumps or go too crazy with it, but it definitely sucks up the bumps. And the adjustability is equal to what's on the Markhor. And it's also, I would say, pretty similar feeling as well. So either one of these I think you'd be good with. Just if you want to go lighter, go with the Manitou. And if you want to have the more fat, beefy Terminator-looking bike, then you go with the Rockshox. It's a more recognizable brand, and it's got the fatter fork legs for street cred. But this is the speeds we're doing on the hardtail. Don't really go much faster than this. In fact, we'll probably retire it at some point and just use it for cross-country local trails because it's a little too much for it to go downhill like this. But switching the Rockshox out and riding these trails versus riding the old crappy Sun Tour was a huge difference. It made a big difference and definitely worth the money.